This is the Morning Swim Show for Friday, September 24th, 2010. I'm your host, Peter Bush. In the Finis Monitor today, we'll talk to Roland Schoeman, the South African sprinter. We'll swim in the Commonwealth Games, which are just about a week away now. Roland joins us right now in the Finis Monitor from Marseille, France. Hey, Roland. Good to talk to you.
Hey, Peter. It's always good to be on here with you.
How's your new training home in France?
I'm loving it. I've been here for a few months and wish it had been longer, learning a lot. It's, at the age of 30, to know that there's still so much left to learn, it's definitely an exciting prospect.
Why France?
I spoke to Brett Hawk while I was still at Arizona, and I said to him, where can you recommend? Where can I go to? I felt like my time in Arizona had come to an end, and I just wasn't a part of the team anymore. It was hard being one of a handful of seniors when you don't really get the attention that you need. Arizona is a university program, and we all understood that. So it's I just said, where in the world can I go to? Can I come to Auburn? Didn't like that idea. But he said, how about Romain Barnier? And I sort of spoke to Romy, and nothing really came of it at that point in time. Stayed in South Africa and got back in touch with Romy and said, you've got Fabien Gillot, you've got William Maynard and Gregory Millet, and would you be interested in having me there with you guys? And he said, come out for a little bit. I went out there for a 2-week sort of trial period and saw what it was like and fit in well. It was the guy got along great with the guys and really fit into the program and found a home away from home. It was nice to finally feel like I belonged in that place. I hadn't had that feeling of belonging in quite some time. So it was I felt that having that sense of belonging and knowing I could have fun there was going to take me a long way.
What's Fabien Gillot like in practice?
He's a good guy. The thing about the French are they're just very, very laid back. They'll train hard. They're intense in what they're actually doing. But there's no backstabbing or smack talking. They get the job done, and that's the most important thing. Their life doesn't revolve around swimming. And I feel like so many people in this world, it's swimming focused just when they're at the pool, when they're away from the pool. These guys just relax. They know how to have fun. They know when they need to be intense. They're all educated about it. All of these guys are professionals. They're not college athletes. They're not juniors. So, it really is a professional group we have there.
What are your expectations for yourself this year?
I really hope that we get to go to Commonwealth Games at this point in time. I'm unsure. There are mixed reports as to whether the games are going to be cancelled or if they're going to continue to go on. It doesn't bode well at this point in time. So, I'd like to go to Commonwealth Games and swim as fast as I've ever swum. I believe right now at this point in time, I've got 21.6 within me. 50 flies. 50 flies has always been easy for me. It's the freestyle that's been a bit of a struggle as of late. Fly. It'd be great to crack the 23-second barrier. I believe both of those are all within my capability. And help the South African team to another relay medal. I think we need to really start building up towards the 2012 Olympics now with the relays again. So to be able to get a silver or ideally gold, the Aussies are not going to lay down for us. So it's I'm looking forward to the fight. And then there's the World Cup Series. I'll be doing all of those and looking to make a little bit of money, and then World Short Course Championships, where I love my short course swimming, so it's I'm excited for that too.
A couple questions off what you just said. You believe you have a 21.6 in you?
Yeah, definitely. I was 22.3 at the Paris Open after I'd only been in Marseille for a couple of weeks and only off a couple of weeks of training. So it's I'm starting to feel like a swimmer again. We've been doing some great work here in Marseille. I was doing some great work back in South Africa on this Marseille program. So I'm feeling like a sprinter again. I'm feeling like an athlete again. So it's I believe it's something that I'm capable of at this point in time. And I'd like my actions to speak louder than words. And I'm just going to go out there and race. If it's a 21.6, so be it. The ideal goal at this point in time for my Olympic committee is to be top 8 in the world, and that's the goal.
Why haven't you had the same success that you had in 2004 since then on the international stage?
In 2004, 2005 were really my best years at Arizona. After 2005, I should have gotten to the point where I said, I've learned all I can learn. I've done all I can learn. at that point in time, I should have looked elsewhere. I think I was still trying to hang on to something that I believed was there, but it wasn't. And I stayed there for a few more years. 2008 was, the Olympics wasn't what I'd hoped for. But yet, straight after the Olympics, I went back to South Africa and broke a world record short course. So, it wasn't there by splits. It was, I was swimming fast, but not when I needed to. So I was missing my taper here and there, and I don't think I was nearly as confident as I had been. It's like I say, I was, grabbing onto things that weren't there. My confidence level wasn't where it needed to be. I wasn't buying into the program as much as I had to. You have to buy into a program 100%, otherwise it's just not going to work for you. And I think in 2006, 2007, 2008, just wasn't working for me. I had my own ideas, and they were conflicting with the coaches at Arizona. And after 2008, I just knew, if I want to carry on swimming, I got to get out of here. I need to find a place where I can, be happy. Happiness was the key factor to me. I just wasn't happy in Arizona anymore. So I had to get out of there, and I'm glad I did. I spent some time at home now, and now's the big push towards the Olympics. So it's there are a couple of reasons why I wasn't nearly as successful as I couldn't be. But short course, I was still performing well, so I knew it's still there. I can't still be the best in the world.
If South Africa is ever to be a medal contender on that 400 freestyle relay again, do you have to become one of the best 100 freestylers in the world?
We proved in 2004 that you can have one or two great swimmers and have two other guys that step up on the day. Lyndon Ferns and Darian Townsend, great 100 freestylers in their own right, stepped up beyond measure. So, you don't have to have four of the world's greatest, but it's going to take a huge effort from all four of us. I believe I've got to get down to, top eight in the world again. A guy like Graham Weir can be that. Gideon Lowe can as well. Lyndon Ferns can as well. So I think, heading into the next Olympics, we can be in a better position than we were heading into 2004. We've got the guys, we've got the talent, we got the will, the drive, and determination. So it's, I'm excited. It's going to be, only time's going to tell.
And it's been so long since we've caught up. Anything else personally that you've been up to? You're not married or anything now, are you?
No, not married. I haven't taken that dive yet. I'm dating seriously. A beautiful girl, Kate Midgley. She's a physiotherapist. So when I do travel, sometimes she's around with me. So it's I fell with my bum in the butter, so to say. So it's life's good. Life's good. I'm missing the States incredibly. It's the States was such a huge part of my life for 10 years. Love to see myself going back there at some point in time, and just trying to make things work in South Africa. It's everybody's butting heads. Everybody has this idea of they have to be in control. Nobody's willing to relinquish their control and really focus on the athletes and the athletes' needs. So that's hard. I remain the outspoken one because I want the best for the athletes in the country. When I'm done with swimming, maybe politics.
Well, you're welcome back in Arizona anytime. Hey, homecoming's just a few weeks away. I'll be there.
Gosh, I wish I could be there this year, but definitely next year, I think. The schedule that we've had this year is just crazy, where we had trials in April. Nobody really shaved and tapered for Pan Pacs, the South Africans. And then we have, beginning of October, the Commonwealth Games, and then again in December, World Short Course. So that's been a long year, so I'm looking forward to it. A somewhat shorter year next year where we can have a little bit of a break and then get into preparations for the Olympics.
Well, hopefully you get to cap it off with a good swim at Commonwealth Games and the games do go on. So, Roland,
if it's not at Commonwealth Games, I hope it's somewhere else.
I'm glad to hear you're doing well. Thanks for joining us.
Yeah, it's a pleasure. Thanks for having me, Peter.
All right, that's Roland Skuman joining us from France, and that is it for today's show. I'm Peter Bush, reminding you to keep your head down at the finish.